Where do you want to be if the you know what hits the fan? If life as we know it, civilization as we know it, changes forever, and we're pretty much on our own, there's a breakdown of systems, and we're pretty much forced to fend for ourselves, protect our own families, and there's no 911, there's no other government entity coming to help us. Where would you rather be? Would you rather be in an urban environment where there's plenty of resources, but there's plenty of a problem individuals around, or would you rather be in a rural area where maybe it's a more tight-knit community, but there's less resources? Well, I want to talk a little bit about this, the advantages and disadvantages of both, simply because I've lived in urban areas. I've also lived in very rural areas. I've lived in Kentucky for the last 9 years. I've lived in Alaska at one point. Also lived in Flint, Michigan. So I haven't really lived in a really big metropolitan area, but a decent sized metropolitan area. Kind of want to talk about some of the advantages. One of the things I will say about urban life is that there's more good people in urban areas than you realize. Obviously, since you have a lot of people living in a small area, well, in a condensed area, more densely populated area, you have much bigger criminal elements. You have bigger stories as far as the media talking about crimes, really heinous crimes. And it's really easy to get a skewed perception of how people really are. Now, the fact of the matter is, yeah, you do have a lot of violent crime in those areas. And a lot of those particular areas have a higher rate of violence. So that's a very real thing that you got to really deal with. One of the advantages, of course, is that they have better shopping, better culture as far as museums. And if that's important to you, they have more resources, even better access to prepping gear. They also have colleges where they have a lot of young, attractive women around. Just a lot of things. There's just a lot of those type of things going on. But then you also have gangs. You also have different type of criminal elements. So the good thing about the cities is that if you're looking for good things, you can find them. Positive things, you can find them. Of course, if you're looking for negative things, you can find them as well. They come in pretty significant levels. Rural areas, if you're into church, if you're into those type of things, if you're into the smaller, slower lifestyle, then that's a really good option for you. There's a lot less resources available. So if you got to get certain things, you got to always find yourself, you got to travel 2 hours a lot of times to get to a decent sized city to get some of the things you want. You won't find a lot of museums or any of that type of stuff there. I had this discussion recently with somebody who came from a very small area. I think it was Phelps or Belfry, actually Phelps. And she was a coworker. She gave me a tour of the area. And that was pretty fascinating. She gave me a tour of the area. I've been in Eastern Kentucky, Pike County, Kentucky for 9 years. And I had never really explored this area. I've been to Atlanta more than I've been to this particular area. I've been a lot of places in Pike County and places like Ash Camp. And I lived in Elkhorn City, a really small town, 1,000 people. I've been to Jenkins in Letcher County a lot. Pikeville, of course. And of course, I've spent a lot of time going up and down US 23, but I haven't spent a lot of time in this area. So she's a coworker, a friend, showed me this area. She actually showed me this really cool diner called Hornets. And had some good food there. By the way, I'll talk more about food later on. I can be a little picky about food. Let's talk about that right now, right off the bat. You guys know I love Five Guys. When I went to Lexington recently, I went to Five Guys Burgers and Fries. Their fries are better than a lot of places I've been. They have better fries and an excellent milkshake. Better than Johnny Rockets. However, Johnny Rockets, I thought their burgers were even better than Five Guys. I mean, that's just my opinion right there. It's harder to find a Johnny Rockets. Not as many of them as Five Guys. Five Guys, you can find them all over the place. But anyway, especially if you're in an urban area. But anyway, this diner that she showed me, Hornets, was actually pretty good. I was actually pretty impressed. I've been here for 9 years, and the only place I only had a limited idea of where you can find good food. But anyway. Our original plan was to go out there and search for this guy who was living in his encampment. Now, I'm not going to show any encampments, homeless encampments, but we visited one site, and poverty in rural areas is just something entirely different compared to urban environments. You have people she told me about this one place where these homeless people are living in encampments. The structures are made out of clothing or something. It's just hard to really believe. But when you actually see this stuff, it's absolutely incredible. It's a completely different world. So our assignment that day was basically to do outreach. We're bringing some resources to this person. We're trying to bring a heater to this individual. And that's one of the things we're working on. And she does a lot of outreach, and that's pretty cool. I like the idea of getting out of the office and actually going out to people and reaching out and actually trying to provide some resources for people. I came down to Kentucky to be a case manager at a rehab. And ever since then, I really responded well to the idea of just getting off my butt and actually interacting and actually just physically making things happen. So anyway, yes, I know I talked a lot about food. I'm still going to the gym, by the way. Yes, I am. That's still a part of my life, and I'm going to continue to do that no matter where I end up, whether it be Texas or Georgia or wherever the heck I end up living. But where would I want to be when, you know, what's the thing? You got to balance that out with, okay, when if there is no big disaster, you know, are you going to be happy spending your life, whatever time you have left, in the place that where you're at? You know, is there going to be a good enough quality of life to justify actually being there? So that's a question, you know, you do got to ask, you know. And where can I go where I can actually connect with people and actually build the type of relationships I need to actually help me in a disaster? Because that's really important when it comes to disasters and emergencies, having people around that you can rely on, people who will have your back. And that's something that a lot of preppers just underestimate. So that's just something I want to talk a little bit about. Where would I rather be? I kind of want to find a really good balance between like a really big metropolitan area, just a decent sized metropolitan area where it's not too big, where the traffic isn't too bad. Of course, that eliminates Atlanta. Atlanta's traffic is terrible. But anyway, just my ideal place would be, I don't know, maybe Knoxville, Tennessee. It really depends. I don't know. I mean, again, I do like museums and stuff, so it really, maybe Nashville, but Nashville is a pretty big place too. So I want to find a place where there's resources, there's culture, there's access to different types of individuals, culturally, something that just opens up new avenues for me. But, you know, also not a place where it's just completely overcrowded, and if something bad happens, we're going to be like crabs in a barrel or something like that. That's... what I'm thinking about. So you guys share your thoughts on this. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Yeah, people can be really nosy in small towns. That's a disadvantage of a small town. You know, it may not be as many bad guys around, but the bad guys that are around are going to be able to get a lot of information on you in small towns because people talk a lot. One of the advantages of a small town is that if you do develop a good reputation, it can really open up a lot of doors for you. So it just depends on what you're looking for. And that can help you in a crisis situation. Something to keep in mind. So, you know, it's something that you have to really think about, figure out what's important to you. And you guys share your thoughts on this.